In this video, we will learn about Bernstein-Vazirani algorithm. The video is organized as follows. We will start by explaining the Bernstein-Vazirani problem definition. Next, we will describe the optimal classical algorithm that can be used to solve this problem. Then we will discuss the oracle separation between BQP and BPP complexity classes and what is meant by the oracle separation. Finally, we will present the quantum algorithm to solve the Bernstein-Vazirani problem. Let's start. Problem definition. Given a black box function that takes n bits inputs and produces 1 bit outputs, you are promised that the function is defined as f of x equals to x dot s. Your task is to find the secret n-bit string s. The black box function implies that we cannot see the internal working of the function. Instead, we are given an oracle to send different inputs to the function and receive corresponding outputs. For example, if secret s is equals to 1101 and x is equals to 1011, then sending f of x 1011 to the oracle will give us logical AND of individual bits of s and x, that is 1 and 1 plus 0 and 1 plus 1 and 0 plus 1 and 1 mod 2 of the whole thing. This will become 2 mod 2, which is equals to 0. Now let's describe the optimal classical algorithm. Classically, this problem can be solved by sending n different inputs to the oracle. In each input, exactly 1 bit, say the kth bit, will be 1, while the rest of the bits will be 0. If the output is 1, it implies that the kth bit of s is also 1, because only 1 and 1 equals 1. Otherwise, the kth bit of s must be 0. Here is a simple example to demonstrate the working of this classical algorithm. Assume that our n is equals to 3 and our secret s that we have to find is 101. We first send the oracle f of 001, where only first bit is 1, while rest of the bits are 0. It gives us 0 and 1 plus 0 and 0 plus 1 and 1 equals to 1. So now we know that the first bit of S must also be 1. Then we send F of 0, 1, 0. The second bit is 1, whereas the bits are all zeros, which gives us 0 and 1 plus 1 and 0 plus 0 and 1, and this is equals to 0, implying that the second bit of S is 0. Finally, we send F of 1, 0, 0, which gives us an output of 1, indicating that the last bit of S is 1. Thus, our secret string S is revealed to be 1, 0, 1. The time complexity of this classical algorithm is big O of n, because we need n calls to the oracle. We cannot achieve better time complexity on a classical computer even using probabilistic algorithms. Bernstein-Vazirani algorithm is the simplest algorithm that provides BQP and BPP oracle separation. Let's learn about it. BPP stands for Bounded Error Probabilistic Polynomial Time. This complexity class contains all algorithms that run in polynomial time and produce the correct result more than 75% of the time using a probabilistic Turing machine. In contrast, BQP stands for Bounded Error Quantum Polynomial Time. This complexity class contains all algorithms that run in polynomial time and produce the correct result more than 75% of the time on a quantum computer. As we have discussed above, optimal classical algorithm to solve Bernstein-Vazirani problem takes big O of n time, whereas the quantum algorithms we will explain next takes big O of 1, constant time. This demonstrates that BQP and BPP are not the same class of algorithms in the presence of an oracle. However, this separation of BQP and BPP, that is, BQP is not equal to BPP, is not yet proved in general when no oracle is present. Let me quickly explain that other quantum algorithms, such as Simon's algorithm, also provide this oracle separation. However, Bernstein-Vazirani algorithm is the simplest one demonstrating this separation. This separation is an important theoretical result to establish the superiority of quantum algorithms as compared to classical algorithms in the presence of oracle. Now, let's discuss the Bernstein-Vazirani quantum algorithm, which is very similar to Deutsch-Hose algorithm. The quantum circuit uses a unitary operator UF, which we use as an oracle. I have a separate video about the UF gate that you should watch. UF takes two inputs and n bit getX and an m bit getY register. The output is the n bits of cat x unchanged and cat y XOR with f of x. In the case of Bernstein-Vazirani problem, our m is equal to 1 as the size of its output is 1 bit. Now, let's create our quantum circuit. We start with an n-bit quantum register containing all zeros, and the second register is of 1 bit and it contains 1. So our initial state, say cat psi 1, is equals to cat 0 raised to power n times cat 1. Next, we apply the Hadamard transformation to both registers. This creates equal superpositions of all possible inputs in our first register, while the second register becomes cat minus. So my cat psi 2 is equals to 1 over square root of 2 raised to power n times the summation of all superpositions of x times cat minus, where cat minus is equals to 1 over square root of 2 times cat 0 minus cat 1. We then input this state into the UF gate. Recall the description of UF gate given above. Our output of cat psi 3 will be the first register remain unchanged, while the second register will be cat 0 XOR with f of x minus cat 1 XOR with f of x divided by square root of 2. Note that f of x XOR 0 is equal to f of x, and f of x XOR with 1 is equal to the complement of f of x. So we substitute this into our cat psi 3, making the second register cat f of x minus cat complement of f of x. Also note that when f of x is equals to 0, the second register will become cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by the square root of 2, which is equals to cat minus. In contrast, when f of x is equals to 1, the second register will become cat 1 minus cat 0 divided by the square root of 2, which is equals to minus cat minus. This means the second register will always have cat minus, and the minus sign phase will appear only when f of x is equals to 1. So I can rewrite the second register as minus 1 raised to power f of x cat minus. Using the concept of phase kickback, I can assign the minus 1 raised to power f of x phase to the first register, making it 1 over square root of 2 raised to power n times the summation from x equals to 0 to 2 raised to power n minus 1 times minus 1 raised to power f of x cat x. I'm not writing the second register, which is there, but not needed in any of the future calculations. We know that in the case of Bernstein-Vazirani problem, f of x is equals to x dot s. So let's substitute x dot s in place of f of x in cat's eye 3. Next, we want to have a gate that converts our first register to cat s so that measuring it will reveal our secret message s. To that end, recall the video where I have explained the general form of Hadamard gates. I provided the link of that video in the description. When a Hadamard gate is applied on cat s, the result will be 1 over the square root of 2 raised to power n times the summation over a new variable, say x, where x takes values from 0 to 2 raised to power n minus 1, times minus 1 raised to the power the product of both of the variables x dot s times cat x. This is exactly our cat's eye 3. Therefore, to get cat s as our result, we have to apply the inverse of Hadamard gate on cat's eye 3. However, as the Hadamard gate is its own inverse, we can simply apply the Hadamard gate on cat's eye 3. The result of this transformation, cat's eye 4, will be cat s. Next, we simply measure it to get our secret message s. That's it. That's our quantum algorithm. The time complexity of this algorithm is big O of 1. This is a constant time complexity because no matter the size of input, we will always call the oracle exactly once. That is it for this video. If you like my video, please consider supporting my channel. Your support is crucial for the survival of this channel. Thank you and see you around. Bye.
You're still here? Go have some fun. Bye.